Hey guys, what's going on? It's RC Knockout, and I am back with another video. Now, if you guys are new to the channel, my name is Nolan, and in today's video, I am doing a three-month review of the heavy-duty drive shafts from eBay that I put on my Traktor / 4x4 VXL. I'm going to tell you guys exactly what I think and whether or not I recommend these drive shafts for you guys to buy as a cheaper option to the MIP drive shafts, which are about twice the price as this. So the MIP ones are about $140. I got these for $74.99 on eBay. So let me move the camera so you guys can get a good look at these drive shafts to see what I'm actually talking about. All right, guys, so to take a closer look at this drive shaft, I'm gonna pop the body shell off real quick. And I will position the RC a little bit better so you guys can see the drive shafts that I am doing the review of. So if you guys can see, these drive shafts are right in here. Hopefully you guys can see what I'm talking about. Got them on both the front and the rear. They've held up very, very well. The only complaint I have is that some of the grub screws start coming loose. So right in here, that grub screw right here is what actually holds the joint together. There's a total of 3 grub screws in each drive shaft. And 2 of them I recommend red Loctite, or at least orange, and then just make sure it stays tight. But I put red in the end. I haven't had to mess with it since. But these ones right here at the joint, that one right there should never have to come out because that's literally what holds the U-joint together. And if you break that pin in there, the drive shaft's done. There's no replacement parts, I don't believe, for that. You'd have to buy a whole new set of drive shafts, at least a new set of 2, because you can only buy them in pairs. So I would highly recommend that you guys make sure these ones right here are tight and have thread lock on them, because you don't want that back out and then losing any of that piece. And there's another one down at the bottom right in here. I hope you guys can see what I'm showing you guys. Right in there, there's another grub screw right there. This is the one that I do not recommend putting red thread lock in. This is the one to actually disconnect it from your differential output shaft. And that I do not recommend putting red Loctite on. I just recommend blue or orange, and then always make sure that one stays tight, because that one can back out. But you also need to access that one from time to time for maintenance purposes. So you don't want to put red thread lock on that. But the other ones, this one right here, and they're all the same size, by the way. They're all 1.5 mil, I want to say. So that one right there, and then the other one that, like I said, is further down here, those ones I recommend putting red thread lock on. And then ever since then, this has stayed together really well. They're telescopic. They're very similar to the stock ones in the way that they work. They have a U-joint just like the stock ones, so it's not a constant velocity. It does have like splined, I guess this would be the outer shaft, and then the inner shaft is also splined to accommodate it, so it's telescopic, as you guys can see. And that's kind of a pretty typical style, I guess. They look really good. They're nice. They're shiny still after 3 months of using it. Tiny bit of rust starting right around there, but as long as they hold up, that's not a big deal. Then the exact same thing to say about the fronts, guys. So basically, maybe you guys can see that the grub screw in there, make sure that has some red thread lock on it, as well as the one right here. Make sure that one has some red thread lock on it. And like I said, they've held up really well. I've bashed this thing pretty hard. I've crashed it pretty hard. I've landed with the power down. I have to say, the only damage I've had that is probably because of these drive shafts is this right here. Now, I was running these stock wheels right here on this rig for a while, and what ended up happening is I spun a hex. And as you can see, it spun that smooth. Like, it completely spun that out, destroyed the hex, destroyed the inner wheel. The good thing is these wheel tires were already damaged, so it's not a big deal. But basically what I ended up doing was I loosened up the slipper clutch, but then I had it too loose. So then the next few times that I ran it, unfortunately then it wasn't getting all the power to the ground. Tighten it up a little bit. I think I have it set right now where there's just the right amount of give, because you wanna make sure you get that dialed in, because what will happen is, normally what would happen is the yoke would break of the drive shaft if you land really hard and there's a big shock through your system. That's the weakest link. It is right in here or down at the actual axle. That's where the breakage point would be on the stock axles, because they're plastic. The plastic ears would actually break off because there's a metal joint within there that's elongating it, and it'll just end up breaking it. But with these, the drive shafts are not the weakest link. So then the next weakest link is gonna be your wheels. So So then what it means is it's going to destroy a wheel hex. And that is exactly what happened. I think this was on the very first run I ran these. So you do have to be careful about that. That when you do upgrade one thing, it then makes another thing more vulnerable. I can't say words. More vulnerable to damage. That wouldn't have happened if I had the plastic drive shafts on. It would have snapped the drive shaft. That's where the shock would have gone. Snapped the drive shaft. I will put in a link in the description for these drive shafts. Highly recommend them. I'm going to keep on bashing with this RC. So far, so good. They've held up better than the other ones I've tried, and they held up a heck of a lot better than the stock drive shafts. And they are a fraction of the price of the MIP shafts. So definitely look into these, guys. If you want to bash your RC and you are sick and tired of replacing the plastic drive shafts, definitely look into this upgrade right here, guys. So if you enjoyed the video, if you feel like you learned something, go ahead, hit that thumbs up button. Also, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so then you'll be notified when I come out with new videos, because there are going to be more videos, there are going to be more updates with this rig further down the line, as well as more bashing videos so you guys can see exactly how hard I'm driving this RC. Just stay tuned and I will see you guys in another video. Later! Also, if you want to watch my original video, the install of these drive shafts and why they're better than the stock ones, I'll go ahead and put a card right up either here or here in this video. I'll figure it out during editing, but I'll put a card up in the corner of this video so you guys can go check out that video.